going.
You bet your boots, cowboy.
This pool's drying up fast, David.
I need oil. Find it.
I'm ready.
Charlotte, get a grip. It's an afternoon engagement party.
You know, looking around, I see a lot of beautiful women. But the most beautiful is my daughter.
You know how I feel about you, Maggie.
You don't have to be alone.
I don't have feelings for you.
I'm taking Rivercross.
But Rivercross is ours. You can't just take it.
I'm not just taking it. I'm taking it back.
It's the loan papers from David. I checked the fine print. It says if we miss 3 payments, he can foreclose on us.
You're paying for the wedding. You don't have to give me Rivercross.
Oh, honey, I...
This is all mine.
Your old man gave you Rivercross. How do the Henrys feel about that?
Do I look like I give a shit?
Guys, you gotta let me back in. It's gonna take something more interesting than 5 G's.
8.
Your brother's Porsche.
Jeez, dude.
Whoa. I can't believe you lost the car.
Lost the what?
Oh, shit.
This family has tiptoed around you long enough. We're staying. I'm staying. This check should do it. This is our home, so get the hell off our land.
Jones, what are you doing?
Not Jones, Kate. Get up.
Hey,
get up. Cattle aren't gonna feed themselves.
I knew there was a reason I left this place.
It's gonna be a very good day.
Oh, yeah? Why is it gonna be so good?
Because the Saudis are refusing to raise production.
Mm-hmm.
Which is exciting the speculative way.
Really?
And that's heating up the futures market. Mm-hmm. And the price of crude is getting higher and higher.
Really?
I can almost feel it rising.
God, I love it when you talk oil.
If we start the wean early, we'll cut down on grain cost. The feeders will do fine with 21 days. That should save at least 3,000.
Coffee first, then cows.
If Mr. McGregor takes the ranch, can we move to New York?
He's not taking the ranch. After what Lucy gave us, we're just $10,000 behind on the payments. I'm going over there to work this out once and for all.
Unless you bring $10,000 with you, it won't work.
Trust me, I know how to handle David McGregor.
So are you gonna sleep with him? Because that's what it's gonna take. What? He asked her on a date, she says no. Next thing you know, he's kicking us to the curb. I'm not connecting dots that aren't there. So if Mum sleeps with Mr. McGregor, we're definitely not moving to New York.
Keep it up and you won't be leaving this house. I've known David a long time. I know how he thinks and why he thinks it. I'll get it.
Hey, Walter, coffee?
No, thank you, can't stay. I just came to tell you ladies thank you. It pains me to say it, but I'm gonna be leaving Rivercross.
What?
I know, I wasn't expecting it either, but I got an offer from another operation, and, well, with the way prices are going, I'm just not foolish enough to turn down that kind of money.
This offer, was it from David McGregor?
I said no 3 times, but with what he's offering...
It's fine, Walter.
To you too.
How could you?
You gonna finish your thought, or do I have to guess what you're angry about?
You know exactly what I'm talking about, Walter. He's been with us for 15 years. What have you become?
The last time I checked, a man was free to work wherever he chooses.
We will not give up, David, even if you buy off every last person in Patterson.
Are we done? Good day, Maggie.
I'm not done. You can try all you want, but you're not taking my home.
I came across a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree. When the big black horse said, look this way, he said, hey, Lady, will you marry me? another one for me. Said no, no, you're not the one for me. You're not the one for me.
Our mother is totally kind. You can't be nice to bullies. They hate you, and you've got to hit back harder.
Who knows? Maybe David will listen to her.
If we're going to beat the McGregors, we're going to have to get mean.
Not the McGregors, just David McGregor. The others are on our side.
Rebecca is not on our side.
Will and Peter are. Rebecca doesn't care about anybody but herself.
Rebecca is Daddy's little girl.
Whatever it is you're thinking, stop it right now.
I'm not thinking anything.
Charlotte. Charlotte! I mean it. You stay away from her.
Oh, you're still here.
Good morning to you, too.
What? I thought you'd be with Trevor.
He's busy with work. D'Artagnan needs a run.
So Will's going to pick me up. We're going to go meet with Dad and see if we could change his mind about taking Rivercross. You want to come?
And why would I want him to change his mind? He's given it to me.
No way. What are you talking about?
As a wedding present. He wants Trevor and I to have a little weekend home to get away to.
No, I don't believe it.
That's their home.
And the Henrys are like family.
I guess that means you're sleeping with your sister. Creepy.
You're the one that's screwing her.
Look, Daddy runs a business, not a charity. So it's really very simple. No pay, no stay.
Well, they're gonna pay.
They certainly are. Good luck. You'll need it.
I gave him $60,000 last week.
Well, we still owe him $10,000 for this month.
Then let's call Nana.
It's not gonna happen.
Oh, so you take money from your daughter, but not your mother?
If I take money from her, it comes with strings attached. You know that.
Why don't we raise some more cattle?
You mean start breeding now?
Why not? Beef prices are high.
When's our next payment to McGregor due?
Next few days.
How's that for an answer? I mean, what good are calves if we don't have a ranch?
We will have a ranch, or are you a quitter?
I work way harder than you do,
girls,
Lucy. I
run this
ranch.
I know how hard you
work. Okay. Long-term, more cattle is a good idea, Kate.
And what about now?
I'll deal with now.
Let's go breed some cows.
Sure, why not? You okay, Mom?
I'll find the money, if only to have the pleasure of ramming it down David McGregor's throat.
The truck smells like a septic tank. I want my Porsche back.
Don't worry, brother, I'm working on it.
Yeah, we'll work harder. Someone might actually see me in this thing.
Why, are you afraid it conches you up too much?
Just don't want to be mistaken for you.
So get this. Rebecca says that Dad's taking Rivercross so he can give it to her.
What?
As a wedding present.
No way.
That's what I said.
We can't do that.
Yeah, I said that too.
Okay, we're gonna have to stick together on this one. And just don't wuss out on me.
No, well, why would I wuss out?
You always wuss out around Dad.
No, I don't.
Just don't.
No, I don't.
You do.
All the time. Just drive, loser.
Such a wuss.
Ah, man!
Tomorrow. Look, you're just gonna have to get used to the whims of your future bride, Trevor. I just want to get a little riding in before I go. I love you. You're not gonna help me now?
I'd rather take you for a ride.
Last time. I'm gonna be married soon.
I don't hear any windmill.
Separate out the heifers so we can start the breeding with the ones who've already calved.
Can't we just turn out Mr. Big and let him go wild?
The cows who've already calved will have the best chance of not dying if they have to birth in the snow.
Do you think this is a mistake? We don't have to do it. I'm only trying to help.
Better late than never.
Remember, don't miss out on me.
Don't worry, I got your back.
You're late. You said 9.
2 minutes?
That's 2 minutes I don't have, not for this discussion. I assume you're here to try to talk me out of taking Rivercross.
I just wanted to ask you about it.
Well, that's a discussion we should have had before you defied me in public. The discussion's over. You started the eviction?
No. You can't do this.
No, I can't, and I'm going to.
Why?
Because I loaned them $200,000. And I get the feeling they're incapable of paying me back.
No, Lucy gave you 60, and that means they're only $10,000 behind. They'll get caught up. Just give them a chance.
No, there'll be no more extensions. Look, I don't expect either of you to understand this, but I'm doing this for Maggie.
You want to break that down for me?
She's trying to hold on to something she should have let go of a long time ago. She doesn't belong on that ranch. She never did.
You're doing her a favor?
Yes.
But since Max died, they've been having a hard time.
Look, it's for the best.
No, this isn't right.
You both work for me. So until you get your own oil company to run, or your own ranch to mismanage, I would appreciate it if you defer to my better judgment on this. We're done.
What happened to I got your back?
You heard him, he's just trying to help them.
What, by taking the ranch? Wow, only you suck at poker.
What are you saying? What does that mean?
What I don't get about you, I mean, you're not afraid of anyone, but you always, always cave around Dad.
You know what? You can get a job anywhere. He sacks me, I'm done. Okay, who's gonna hire me? I burned too many bridges, huh?
Yeah, you know what? Maybe if you just tried a little harder. Huh? I mean, if not for yourself, hey, buddy? At least for your girlfriend.
It's not my girlfriend, we're friends.
Yeah, don't count on that. And get me my damn car back.
Yes.
I'm tired of your excuses.
All right.
You hear me?
What the hell is wrong with you? I'm afraid to open my mouth.
So don't.
Why are you so mad at me?
It's not you.
Peter, right? I know you guys have been seeing each other. Just because I haven't been here doesn't mean I don't hear things.
We're not seeing each other. We just hang out sometimes.
But I get it. You're just friends. With benefits.
His father's trying to take her home. You think he might have at least called me?
Peter's a good guy, Kate. Just give him some time.
We don't have time right now.
We're gonna be okay. Mr. Big's gonna make us some babies, aren't you, Mr. Big? Go make us proud!
I think we have a problem.
Craftsman. My family passed it on to me when I got married.
You finished this?
Yes.
Shouldn't have.
Oh, there's a really interesting story behind this chair. My husband's family was originally from Kent, and the chair...
Look at this grain. You don't get craftsmanship like this anymore.
No, you don't. My husband made those doors himself.
Shame about the damage.
Oh, those are just, I mean, they're just marks to record the kids' heights over the years.
Well, that's interesting.
To you.
$3,500. And that's for the table, the cabinet, and the picture frames.
That's not enough.
More than fair.
Okay, this is my family's history here. That's not enough. $3,500 is...
Are you sure you don't have anything else?
No.
And that's the best I can do.
I need 10.
No, you're not gonna get it from me. Sorry.
tried to tell you I was coming, but you've clearly been avoiding me.
I've just been busy.
It's okay. I understand that this can't be easy. I know what David's trying to do.
Ladies!
Hi.
Hey.
I'm just gonna go.
Did you tell Lucy about us?
What's to tell?
Damn. You're mad at me, too.
It's because I didn't call, isn't it? Oh, yeah, she's mad. What was I supposed to say? I'm sorry my dad's kicking you out of your house. You wanna sleep together? Listen, I promise you, I'm not gonna let him take your ranch. No, you're gonna have to admit that you were mad. You might upset the balance of the universe. You might cause water to run uphill and leaves to turn purple. Leaves turning purple. You don't want purple leaves, do you?
No.
Me neither.
Okay, I was mad.
That's my girl.
Hey. Oh, that cheating bastard. Yeah, well, his day's about to take a turn for the worse. Thanks, man. It's about Will's car. I have to go, but I'll call you.
It's always something, Peter.
What?
She's the best real estate agent in town, and she's expecting your call.
I am not selling.
I can see how hard this is for you, but there's something you need to understand. There's no shame in failing. I mean, look at me, three husbands, I should know, but every time I've been down and out, I've always managed to get back up on top. But the first thing I needed to do was admit I'd made a mistake.
I didn't make a mistake. I loved my husband more than you will ever know.
But he's gone. No, and it's time to move on.
Like you did, so I should find myself a Martin.
I did what I needed to do to take care of my family. It's what a good mother does.
I know how to take care of my family.
Of course you do. It's astonishing how well you've done on your own. But, you know, you're still a beautiful woman. You don't need to struggle like this.
I raised my kids here. I love this place.
All I'm saying is right now you have options. And it might not always be like that. You can't blame me for caring.
I don't. Thanks for dropping by, Mom.
It's fine. You know, maybe, just maybe, it would be possible to sit down with David and have a friendly chat, you know, work things out.
So you talk to him?
He cares about you, Maggie.
He's a bastard.
He's a good man, and I wish you could see that.
No, he's just a rich man. Actually, there is a difference.
Oh. Well, you give my best to the girls.
Nana! Oh, hi, I didn't know you were coming.
Well, if you never call me, how would you know?
It's been a little nuts lately.
Yeah.
Are you leaving?
Oh, I think I've overstayed my welcome. 15 minutes. Some sort of a record. Call me. I'll take you shopping.
Don't you want to say hi to Kate?
Oh, bring her with you. I'm sure both of you could stand to get away from this place for a while.
You know, he's actually convinced himself he's doing them a favor. You know, he's kicking them out of their house because it's best for them. And my stupid brother just sits there and buys his crap. You even listening?
Deluded father, acquiescent brother, and a profound need to protect this family.
No, it's just, she's like a sister to me.
That's interesting.
What?
Well, you never talk about the other sister. It's always Lucy. When did you sleep with her?
I didn't.
That explains it.
What was that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Am I prettier than her?
You know, I don't like this game.
Wrong answer.
Hey, what are you doing?
Mixing up a batch of Brave Bull. I found a recipe for it in one of Dad's old almanacs.
An herbal tonic to increase bull activity during breeding season.
You can't hurt to try. Hey, are these baneberries?
Yeah.
How many do I need?
It says you need 5.
I think it's the magic ingredient.
This is never gonna work.
What is that?
Bellagra. Mr. Big needs to pick me up. Hey, why was Nana here?
Nana was here?
Just left.
She came to gloat.
Did that gloating happen to come with a check?
I won't take her money.
Mr. Big better come through for us.
I'm getting your car back. A buddy of mine called Blake, the guy I lost it to, with a loaded deck, and he hangs out at the Indigo, so I'm gonna go over there and have a little chat with him.
Yeah, well, look, I don't want you getting into any kind of trouble.
No, no, he's the one in trouble. Nobody cheats me without bringing on some serious hurt. Come on!
Wait for me, okay?
Don't worry, I'm gonna handle it. Bye.
I've been dealing with your bank for years now. I know I realize that we're still in debt on this place, but we have launched a very aggressive breeding program, and I think we're actually gonna be overrun with cattle 9 months from now, so. But I would call that collateral. Thank you. Thank you. Jerk.
Hey, Maggie. You have a second?
Yeah. Come on in. Thank you for the kind offer, but the answer is no. No charity.
Look, it's just a loan, okay? $10,000 to make your next payment.
No offense, but I got into this mess by borrowing money from your father.
Look, okay, I'm sorry about my dad. Hey, but I am not him.
I know that.
You did so much for me after my mom left. Okay, this is just it's a small way of saying thank you.
I'm sorry. I just can't take it. But I really appreciate the offer.
If you change your mind.
I won't.
Well, he seems to like it. You really think this is gonna work?
Only one way to find out.
Come on.
Shadows went reaching across the long desert sands, and the cows went bowing their heads. Was the galloping footprints of
oh my god, it worked.
Went riding through the night, went riding out.
Uh-oh, cow boy!
Easy now, saddle cow. This time is growing thin.
That's not good. Is he okay?
No. He's dead.
sorry.
He was an old bull. It's okay. We'll get a higher pregnancy rate with artificial anyway. It's just expensive is all.
How much?
About 5,000. So I don't know what we're gonna do. Nana.
We need to talk.
Girls, give us a minute. And go share a drink on me.
Oh. Yeah.
Hey.
You know, that was my recreation.
Oh, I was just wondering if you had any more games coming up.
Yeah, I got one on Friday back at John's place. You want in?
Well, I was talking to a couple of friends, and they're interested in playing.
Yeah, well, who are they?
Oh, I just know their nicknames, Striker and Meat. They said that they played with you before. Said things about settling accounts. What do you know about that? Huh? You didn't cheat them or anything, did you?
No.
Well, I don't know. They said that you used a marked deck or something. Man, I sure hope not. But hearing that, it kind of makes me think that you cheated me out of my brother's car. How's that Porsche running for you, anyway?
Fine.
Fine? $140,000 car. Fine?
No, it's good.
You know what I was thinking? That maybe you hand me back the car, and maybe I tell Stryker and his buddy that you left town. How about that?
Just maybe.
Where's the car?
Well, you see, that's the thing. I don't have the car.
Okay, you want to talk to Stryker here? That's fine. Or you want to wait till Friday at John's?
I gave the car to Ricky.
Okay, just call and find out where it is.
You know, if I were you, I wouldn't go there.
Yeah, okay, but you're not me. Hey, who's Ricky?
Trouble?
Just find out where it is.
Sure, it's your funeral.
Just find out where the car is, Blake.
How did you know it was me? No one else would have the guts or, quite frankly, the stupidity to take me on.
Not sure I'm the stupid one. I'm not the one sleeping around on my fiance.
You really aren't like them, are you? Like who? Your sisters. Kate, always so serious, the whole world would fall apart without her. And Lucy, she's so cute and bubbly, everybody just loves Lucy. But nobody really understands Charlotte, do they?
We're here to talk about Rivercross.
Are we? Frankly, I'm shocked you even care about that dumpy old ranch.
It's my home.
You deserve better. You think I don't notice how you look at me? By my clothes, my car. I'll bet you even know what kind of shoes I'm wearing.
Jimmy Choo's.
See, you're not like them, Charlotte.
No, I know what you're trying to do here.
Of course you do. You're a smart girl. I think we've established that.
You tell your dad to lay off. And if he doesn't, I swear to God, I will send those pictures to everyone.
Some hard times, I won't deny it, but we're starting to turn things around.
And maybe if you supported the ranch a little more, you and Mom might start to get along better.
Oh, really? And how am I supposed to do that? You could help us with the loan.
We think we have a way to turn things around, but it's gonna take a little money.
How much?
Just 5,000.
What's it for?
Equipment.
I think you both know how I feel about this ranch project. Honestly, I might as well just burn my money, but tell you what. If you can get your mother to a family gathering where we're all together, at least pretending to be a happy family, you can have the money.
Snake Ridge isn't looking good.
How deep are we?
4,600. Might be time to put a bullet in it.
All right. Call it. Me and a half bucks gone.
1.8, actually. That shale's been a bitch.
Shit. Okay, how long before Copper Creek's played out?
Oh, probably a few months. That milkshake's gone. We're just sucking on bubbles now.
Well, then tell me you have some new prospects.
Not in the other sites. I did find a head scratcher. Came across an old seismic that your dad shot in the 70s.
This map.
Where?
Right here. Right in your own backyard.
Doesn't make any sense. Why would my father bury something like that?
That's one hell of a good question, because these formations are real high. I mean, we're talking easily 20 meters of structure in the sweet spot.
You sure it's here?
Yeah. What? David, this is great news.
That's Rivercross.
What's Rivercross?
That's a property the bastard gave away.
Okay, there it is.
We don't need to do this.
But you want your car back.
Yeah, I mean, we should just call the cops. I mean, come on, it's obviously illegally parked, right? It's not my car.
What do you mean?
Those are my plates.
Give me the key. Just give me the key. See, it is your car. Okay, you want to drive?
No, just go get it.
Had a bit too much to drink. I've been looking for all night.
You want to take me for a ride?
Depends on what you're really asking.
Come on.
Hey! What the hell do you think you're doing?
That car back. Make sure she gets the good china.
You mean the ones without the chips in it?
Yes.
Can't believe you invited her here.
She's our Nana. We love her.
Then why don't you go to her place?
Oh, come on, Mom. It's gonna be fun. It's family.
Surprisingly, those two words are not always synonymous.
Don't worry, we're gonna have a great time.
Second September, I have known you.
Charlotte! You coming to dinner?
Do I have to?
Yes, she's your grandmother.
Whatever, you don't even like her.
Well, she's my mother, I'm not supposed to like her.
But I do love her. You're good.
So put on something nice, okay, and get out here.
I was glad to let the whole thing go. It was taken by the wind and snow, and I still didn't know that I
woo-hoo!
Oh, my girls, look at you. Oh, you both look just fabulous. If I had a camera, I would take a picture.
White or red, Nana?
Oh, sweetie. You know, I can't believe that I drove up here twice in one week. I wanted to take you to Chez Lucien. They have an outstanding date-stuffed Chilean sea bass.
We're having pork chops.
Well, in that case, red.
Better open a few.
Isn't this just lovely, all of us together like this? Where's Charlotte?
She's still getting changed. Oh. Oh.
Oh, Canadian wine. Honestly, Maggie, you should know better. Oh, no.
Evening, Lucy. Like
whatever it is you're doing here, now's not the time.
Actually, Teddy invited me. Excuse me. Sorry I'm late. One of my favorites, ladies.
What is he doing here?
You didn't tell her?
Well, I was just about to. I know that this may seem a little awkward given the circumstances, but I invited David to join us for dinner. There's no reason the two of you should be fighting.
You mean apart from the fact he's trying to take our home?
I'm sure if we all just sit down and talk about it, we can sort it out. I mean, you two used to be in love. I'm sure Teddy, you can reach some sort of resolution.
Look, it doesn't have to be like this, Maggie. Look, when Teddy called, I just thought this was an opportunity to put this whole thing behind us.
Exactly.
I mean, our families have always been close. I just hate to see us torn apart like this.
So do I, David.
Well, I want to make this right.
Really?
Yes. In an effort to, mend fences. I'm willing to offer you double the market value for Rivercross.
No.
Get out.
Be reasonable, Maggie.
Get the hell out of my house!
I'm not going to make this offer again.
Oh, David, I'm so sorry.
No. Enjoy your dinner.
Honestly.
Guess we're not getting that farm equipment.
I have an idea. Don't worry. This time it's a good one.
Or should I say rustlers?
It's not what it looks like. We were just borrowing him.
I didn't see anything. Did you see anything?
Oh, not a thing, man.
Thank you. So what is going on with them?
No, I don't know if they even know. So, is it nice to be back?
Yeah, surprisingly it is.
Good. Hey, so next time you're in the city, why don't you give me a call? We'll go for a drink.
Yeah. You want to get that?
Oh, Hey, you know what? I'll call her back.
Her?
It's just some girl I've seen a few times.
Oh.
I should go.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks for the bowl.
Yeah.
The safety of the universe, I'm going to assume that you're still mad at me.
That's probably best.
You sure about this?
To do something.
You tried to steal his bull.
We're just trying to help, Mom. We're just trying to make this place work.
It's okay. I can handle it. I can get us out.
How, Mom? You think everything we try is stupid? You won't take Nana's help?
No, I won't.
Well, what do you want to do? Move bills around on the table and imagine they're going to pay themselves? I'm sorry.
Be careful, love. I can't be there with you. Be careful, love. But I'll keep worrying too. Forget about your lover.
Most of it was my husband's. A couple of gifts from my mother. She has impeccable taste in shiny things.
Now that's one heck of a rock.
That was my engagement ring.
Your husband must have been some sweet on you. How much you want?
It's not for sale.
You sure? Could we sell a big blue diamond like that in a snap?
What's your offer?
$8,000.
For the ring?
For the lot.
No. Make it 11.
It's not worth 11.
11,000. Boss would kill me.
I'll go 95.
I need 10.
And I need a lap dance from Angelina Jolie, but that's not gonna happen either. Look, I'm sure you can scare up the other five.
I need $10,000. I need $10,000 to save my family's ranch. The guy who gave me this ring, the one who was sweet on me, his blood is in the walls of that place, and so is mine. I mean, I can lose the ring, but the home that he built for me and his daughters.
That's Tony Lamas.
~100% Vaquero. They don't even make this style anymore, you know.
Is Mr. McGregor expecting you?
I hope not.
Well, this all sounds very... Maggie, I'm in the middle of a meeting.
Oh, this won't take a minute.
Well, I'm sorry about this.
There's the $10,000 I owe you. I'm sure you get someone in your office to count it. Unless, of course, you'd like to take the pleasure yourself. Done the same thing.
Mom!
Coming!
The least we could do.
Considering you are selling the clothes off your back for us.
You heard.
Open it.
They're not as nice as your old ones.
But all the cool kids are wearing them.
Thank you.
Try them on.
We're gonna make a go of this place no matter what.
I know that. But hopefully before I lose the rest of my wardrobe.
I'm not sure that would be the worst thing in the world.
Shut up. Thank you.
Now you can help with chores.